большая часть вот этих вот выделяемых в Средиземноморском регионе в большом количестве скальных, подземных, мегалитических руин.
Most part of the ruins of rock, underground and megalithic towns and structures or underground terrestrial megalithic complex widely developed in Mediterranean region are overbuilt in many places by the ruins of later towns, which date back in different places from the 10th millennium BC up to the 1st millennium AD. In Spain, Italy, Israel and other countries, both those and other ruins are widely overbuilt by also in medieval formations. In some places we can see formations like puff cake. On a rock complex building stone blocks of 2nd or 3rd millennium BC lay with erosion and disagreement with pockets filled with alluvial and colluvial deposits. They are themselves destroyed and overbuilt by later constructions. All this ends with medieval towns. This we see constantly. Excellent examples are Serrana, Savana, Pitigliana, Orte and other cities in Italy, Boquerant, Esper's castle in Spain. We can give many examples of similar cities in France and other countries. That is, younger civilizations for some reason inherited the ancient rock complexes.
Pitigliana, Orte и многие другие в Италии, Boquerant в Испании, Эспера, замок в Испании, ну и масса может таких сооружений во Франции привести и в других городах.
What was the reason for this? With the fact that it was convenient to build? With the fact that there was already the remains of walls? On the ancients built on energy active zones and there was positive energy. We do not exactly know this now, although we can assume that perhaps there really was positive energy. However, the fact is obvious. Such puff cakes we see everywhere. Another fact is that archaeology determines the age of rock formations lying at the base on the basis of determining the age of overlapping structures. And it turns out, look, that it's a paradox. In some places, overlapping rock complex ruins date the 3rd-1st millennium BC. Their age determined by the remnants of ceramic skulls, bone residues. In other places, for example in the Crimea, the cairn structures lying over the rock complex date back to the 6th, 11th centuries AD. Based on these dates, the age of rock complexes is determined. However, rock complexes are the same everywhere. What is in the Crimea, what is in Spain, what is in Turkey, what is in Israel. They generally do not differ from each other. Rock structures like twins, brothers. It can be seen from the degree of erosion, the character of fracturing, the confinement to the Neogene planation plane or surface that they were built by the same civilization. At a later time, different civilizations built their own structures on them. Only one built in the 10th millennium BC, others in the 3rd millennium BC, and others in the 11th century AD. Naturally, these late constructions have no reason to transfer to these dumb rock complexes and there is no need. I managed to explore rock, underground and megalithic structures in different regions of the Mediterranean region and get a large number of their photos from my familiar researchers, as well as reports on the study of structures in other countries, which I have not seen. This once again confirmed my opinion that the whole of Europe and the Near East is a Neogene country or a number of countries that had a dense population in which the Neogene's infrastructure was preserved. The study of materials on Iraq, Afghanistan, Syria, Iran, Pakistan, India, especially China, shows that all Neogene rock structures can be traced far to the east. They are the same in Iran and in Iraq and in Pakistan and in South China. There are a lot of them here, that they are at even higher altitude. This indicates that the Neogene global civilization was not only in Europe, it extended to the eastern outskirts of Asia. Judging by the materials that are now coming from South America, almost the entire Andean belt from Chile to Venezuela, Colombia and Central America, the western part of South America in fact is exactly the same rock underground megalithic complex. Blavatsky wrote about the fact that there are many underground towns. Wilkins also wrote about this in his book Secrets of South America. A lot of information about the underground cities of South America I received from an honorary member of the Academy of Sciences of Peru, Yuri Zubrinsky, whom I knew personally. Recently, Andrei Zhukov brought from his expeditions a lot of photos showing that, in addition to the well-known temple complexes of Tijuana, Sacsayhuaman, Cusco, and many others in the west of South America, their formations carved in rock now will have a large number of video and photos of them. They are no different from the rock underground megalithic complexes in Europe and Asia. They have about the same Neogene age. Thus, we see that the Neogene civilization was so global that it was not limited to Europe and Asia, but included at least western part of South America.